Manor Street School was built in 1863, and for over 100 years the children of Braintree came to school here. After it closed, it stood empty for some time until in 1993, when the main building was converted and opened as the new premises to house Braintree District Museum. The museum has been so successful that it needed to expand, and in 2003, with the help of a lottery grant, work began in converting what had been the infant school into a new Learning for Life centre. As part of the development, it had been decided that the time capsule should be buried. This was to contain items and pictures of today. All the schools in the district were invited to bring things to put in the time capsule.
Who is going to accept a small gift to go into the time capsule from each of the Braintree schools, and Leslie Killen will call the schools out one at a time.
blocking Church Street. John Bunyan Junior School. Yeah, we've got it.
Excellent.
Oh, we have got special. Well, we've got special bags for the paintings, so we may have to take those out. No, all these paintings have to go.
Put it in the plastic container.
Lions Hall.
Construction and a photograph of the staff at the museum, and also the fundraising brochure that helped to raise the money from the lottery.
And newspapers? Today's newspaper and the breakfast.
And good afternoon, everybody. I'm having a little list to say thanks to. First one on the list is the contractors, W.P. Harris, thank you very much indeed. The architect, Mark Lewis of BDC Architectural Services. Quantity surveyor, Brian Lam of Flutie and Robinson. A mechanical engineer, Peter Campbell of Ingleton Woods. And our structural engineers, Ken Rush Associates. Of course, the companies and individuals who have helped raise money towards the National Heritage Lottery Fund Award, in particular, Crittle Windows, who are generously sponsoring the windows in the new link. That's excellent. Also here today are all the children from the Braintree Primary Schools, and we thank them for their attention.
You can see me, obviously, here, doesn't it? Let me pick at the end to move right in.
We need to go in the hall to get the phone in, otherwise.
It's just that I need a washer and the thing underneath.
No, I'm that.
Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Louder!
That's now let the children jump on it.
Yeah, jump on it.
Yeah, they might go through.
but apart from welcoming you all this evening, my job really is to thank the sponsors in particular for all their help, for their dedication here to make this project work how it has. Also to the contractors, because love them or loathe them, you need to be on their side and they need to be on your side, and obviously it's worked here because they've really done such a good job. And obviously the volunteers. Without the volunteers, I'm sure none of this would have happened.
And 2000. But above all, this evening we are celebrating the opening of the former infant school building in which you're standing into the Learning for Life Centre. This has been achieved with the support of a Heritage Lottery Fund grant of £371,000. So we are deeply indebted to the Heritage Lottery Fund. But I must tell you that one of the most sensational achievements of our working together since 1999 in relation to this building and our associated and related works, we have in fact raised £1 million, which I think is some achievement. And I'd like to thank everybody who supported the museum and who's helped in any way whatsoever towards raising the money, because £1 million is a very significant sum. Finally, I want to pay a special tribute to Jean Grice and her team for the mountain of work and dedication required to achieve the lottery award and the completion of the major works in securing the opening of this Learning for Life Centre this evening.
Just finally, I'd like to thank all of the people who have already been thanked once, but they can't just be thanked once, and then it should be thanked so many times, because without the sort of volunteer effort and the dedicated profession effort we've had, we wouldn't be here today, and this building wouldn't be here today. So I think if I am the last speaker, which I possibly am, then I think one final round of applause for everybody who's created this wonderful building. Younger people in particular to find out about their heritage and their past.